So student, in previous lecture we discussed hydroformylation reactions where we can use dicobalt octacarbonyl as a catalyst. So now in this lecture we discuss the next reaction, which is called as the Wacker process. So see, this is nothing but say reaction where we got aldehyde as a product. So in the similar way, in say the previous reaction, that is in hydroformylation reaction, we also got the aldehyde as a product, and in this reaction we also got the aldehyde as a product. But the difference in between the hydroformylation reaction and the Wacker process is that this is what say the Wacker process. So here, suppose if we take a alkene, this is nothing but said to be the CH2 double bond CH2. So here we can consider the symmetrical alkene, and when we do say the hydroformylation reaction over it in presence of say the H2, and this is nothing but said to be the dicobalt octacarbonyl. So we got such type of product, so which is what CH3, CH2, and this is what CHO. Okay, so when we compare the number of carbon atoms in reactant and product, so in the reactant we have only 2 carbon atoms. Okay, and in product we have first, second and third. So we have what, 3 carbon atoms in product. So in hydroformylation reaction, so the product, they have one more carbon atom as compared to the reactant. So when we move towards what say the Wacker process, so when we do say the same reaction or the same reactant, that is what the symmetrical alkene, this is nothing but said to be the half H2O in presence of catalyst. I may simply write down over here as a catalyst. Whenever we saw the reaction, when we discuss the reaction, so we can write down it. Okay, so this is nothing but the same reactant as we take in the hydroformylation reaction, and when we do the Wacker process over it, so we got what, such type of product, so which is nothing but the CH3CHO. Okay, so here in Wacker process, when we saw say the number of carbon atoms in the reactant and the product, so which are same. So here we have 2 carbon atoms in the reactant as well as the 2 carbon atoms in the product. So this is nothing but the major difference in between the hydroformylation and the Wacker process. Means in hydroformylation reaction, the product, they contain one more carbon atom as compared to the reactant, and in Wacker process the number of carbon atom in the reactant and product are same. So this is what say the main difference in between these two reactions. Now we try to understand what do you mean by the Wacker process. So simply just we consider this reaction. This is nothing but said to be standard reaction for Wacker process. So this is what CH2 double bond CH2. So this is our simple alkene, symmetrical alkene, and plus this is nothing but said to be the half H2O we will take. Why? Because we are doing the oxidation, so hence we can take say the oxygen, or you can say that the as a oxidizing reagent. And here the catalyst is nothing but said to be the PdCl2, PdCl4. Okay, PdCl4 and similarly PdCl4 and CuCl4. So these are nothing but said to be the 2 complexes we are going to use as a catalyst in the Wacker process. And whatever say the product we got, which is nothing but the CH3CHO, means here the number of carbon atoms in product and reactant are same. Now we move towards what say the mechanism of this reaction. Okay, so we'll explain the mechanism of this reaction in the same manner as we explain in the hydroformylation reaction. So in first step, we just say concentrate over say the structure of the PdCl4 and CuCl4. Okay, so student, let me know that whenever we come across what say the complexes of PD as well as what say the Cu, so the complexes of PDNCU they most often present in the square planar geometry. Must have. Okay, they don't have any other. And they must be present as a PDCl4 and CuCl4. And they have the di-negative charges over complex. So here, this is nothing but said to be the PD. Okay, and they have, this is what, one Cl. This is the another Cl. This is the another Cl. And this is what, say, the fourth Cl. So these are nothing but said to be the 4 Cl, which is surrounded by means of this PD. Okay, and the total charge is nothing but said to be the total charge over the complex is nothing but said to be the -2, because the PD which is present in the +2 oxygen state and 4 Cl is 4-, so the +2 and -4, so -2. So here the total charge over this complex is nothing but the -2. So when this complex is reacted with what say such type of alkene, which is nothing but the reactant of our reaction, okay, so what happened? The Cl will going to replace. So one Cl will going to replace by means of this alkene. So here there is a elimination of one Cl. Okay, there is a elimination of one Cl. So here we can write down what the -Cl-. Okay, and there is a formation of the pi complex in between the PD and this double bond of what, say, the alkene. So here such type of product we got. So here this is what a Cl. This is nothing but the another Cl. This is nothing but the another Cl, and this is what said to be the CH2. It is doubly bonded with this CH2. So this is nothing but said to be the, you can say that the product of first step. Okay, product of first step, you can say that the intermediate. Okay, next what happened? There is the addition of what, say, the H2 molecule in this. So we can write down here what, say, this PD. Okay, this is what, one Cl, this is second Cl, this is the third Cl, and this is nothing but said to be the CH2, which is doubly bonded with, say, another CH2. So there is an addition of what, say, H2O over here. So we can say that the H2 is nothing but said to be the ligand which having oxygen, which having what, the 2 lone pair, and there is a replacement of one Cl exactly opposite to that of what, this alkene. So the exactly opposite Cl of that alkene is nothing but this one. So that Cl will going to replace by means of this H2O. So here you can say that -Cl-, and what we got here, here this is what, say, the PD, here one Cl, this is nothing but the CH2 doubly bonded with CH2. Okay, this is Cl, and this is nothing but said to be, yeah, here what we write down, here what we write down is nothing but the H2. Okay, H2O. So here we got what, the H2O. So we can write down like that, H2O or OH2. So simply in next step what happened, we again reacted this molecule with what, say, the H2O, because see here, this is nothing but here is nothing but said to be the H2O, which having, say, you can say that the 2 hydrogen present over this oxygen atom. So when we reacted this molecule with again H2O, so one hydrogen will going to, say, eliminated with, say, the another molecule of H2O as a H3O positive, and we got OH over here. So we can write down this third step. So this is what, say, the PD, this is Cl, this is what I may write down H2O. Okay, this is nothing but Cl, second Cl, and this is what, say, the alkene, CH2 double bond, what, CH2. So here again we reacted with what, H2O. So what H2O will do, so this is what, say, lone pair. So this lone pair will going to abstract one of the hydrogen atom present over this H2O. Okay, so what we got here, this is what, -H3O positive. Okay, because this H2O will going to bring one hydrogen along with it. So here what we got, here we got OH. Okay, so this is what, say, the PD, this is what, Cl, this is another Cl, this is CH2 double bond CH2, and this is what, OH. Okay, so this is what, say, the resultant complex, or you can say that the product of this step. Now the isomerization will be take place. Okay, so what do you mean by the isomerization? Here this is what to be the fourth step, in which what, say, the isomerization will be take place. So this is PD, this is Cl, this is what, another Cl, this is what said to be the CH2 double bond CH2, and here is nothing but said to be the OH. So simply what happened, isomerization, or you can say that the there is a change in the position of that Cl and OH will be take place. So the isomerization reaction will be take place. Means what? That OH will goes over here and that Cl will goes over here. This is nothing but said to be the reaction. So what we got? We got what here? This PD. Okay. Here what we got? Here OH. Here is nothing but said to be the CH2. Okay. This is what CH2. This is Cl. Okay. This is nothing but the second Cl. So the question arises that why this reaction will take place, or what is the importance of say the isomerization reaction in this step? Because whenever this OH will say present at this side, this is what say the cis side of the with respect to this alkene, so that OH will going to insert, okay, or reacted with this alkene. So we will going to show in the next step. So this is what the fifth step. So in this step what happens? So this is said to be the PD, okay, this is what said to be the OH, okay, this is what Cl, this is what say another Cl, and this is nothing but said to be the double bond CH2, and this is what said to be CH2. So here what happened, that OH will going to attack over here and this CH2 will say attack over here. What we got? We got over here say the PD, which is present in zero oxidation state, plus Cl, okay, plus SCl, okay, and plus say our product, that is nothing but the CH3CHO, okay, which is nothing but say our product. So this is nothing but our product. Along with that we got say the PD, which is present in the zero oxidation state, SCl and the Cl. Again, suppose if we know that at the beginning we are using say the two complexes as a catalyst in this reaction, which are nothing but PdCl4 and CuCl4, okay. So now, so here this is nothing but said to be say the PD, which is present in the zero oxygen state, further reacted with in last step. So this is what say the PD, which is present in the zero oxidation state, it is reacted with what say the CuCl4 dinegative, okay, CuCl4 dinegative. So we got what say here, this is said to be the PdCl4 dinegative. Here we can take twice, plus CuCl4 dinegative. So here our catalyst is, you can say that the recyclize, okay, and it can be further used in this reaction, okay. So this is all about what say the Wacker process, okay. If you have any difficulty in this reaction, so you must have to ask, okay. Thank you.